Ooh, we got a twitcher. Look at that. It's twitching on its own. We got our buddy Nick here. Nick can't seem to keep the rip aside down. He's crashed on his one wheel, has crashed many times on his mountain bike, and so he's separated both of his AC joints on both shoulders. So we're gonna be working on his shoulders. He also is a rock climber, so he's got some inside elbow pain, probably some golfer's elbow pain. So we're gonna be taking a look a little bit at that. And he hasn't gotten any body work for a while, so we're gonna kind of just see what we can do in about an hour. So yeah, here we go. A little bit of almond oil. Just gonna be scanning for a little bit of tension here. Always like to start out the massage with firm pressure. Schadl's table doesn't really do light pressure. Pretty much everybody knows that. Almond oil. It's really cheap. You can buy it online. Got a link below in the description. Just kind of gets absorbed into the skin nicely. And then I don't have to really reapply it much. And you can put some healing elements in there, maybe some menthol, camphor. I use some stuff, I think it's called Dr. Bob's. Just kind of checking out that low back. Pretty much everything feels tight on Nick. Might need a 4-hour massage. Just gonna kind of come in here, slide down along the erectors. Sometimes we feel pain in our hip flexors and in our hips. Oftentimes that can come from this quadratus lumborum. I'm just gonna anchor that right elbow. Come in here with the left elbow. Slowly drag. Stretch out the erectors. Right above that iliac crest. Still looking for tension in other spots. Upper trap feels really tight. Rhomboids, middle trap. This guy needs some work. I'm just grabbing that lat. Definitely got some rounding. Looks like everything is pulling them forward. Probably biceps, pecs, pec minor, pec major. Since he does a lot of rock climbing, the lats, biceps can get really tight and kind of create this little bit of a thoracic rounding. Puts a lot of pressure on the neck. All right, so we're gonna try to release this lat here. Teres major, super tight. Oh, we got some twitching there. That's definitely going to free up the shoulder, releasing that teres major. And you can see the muscle releasing. That's going to be pretty tender for most people, but Nick's pretty tough. Maybe we want to come in here with a elbow. And we're just gonna pin ourselves against that teres major. There we go. Still getting lots of release. Oh, that's a good spot. You can kind of feel the muscle pushing right back at you. Oh, we've got serratus anterior right there up against the rib cage. Lat. And of course, teres major. I'm just stacking my thumb. Let's see if we can get some more twitching here. This is another great thing. You can come to the other side and just grab that lat, pinch down. Just feel the muscle softening, not so hypertonic, it's being flooded with blood, nutrients. This is gonna help get rid of this rounding here. Let this shoulder drop down. What a lot of people experience with trigger point work and referral patterns is I'll pinch here and hold, and often the client will talk about feeling referral down the arm. Sometimes when we feel pain in another place, we worry that it's nerve pain. In reality, it's really just a tight lat causing pain down the arm and into your fingers. Lots of trigger point releasing there. We really have to be patient in releasing muscles. Slow it down. Just have to surrender to the pain. Life is full of pain. Kind of feels good to get a deep tissue massage and get all the tension out. Sometimes life doesn't feel so tough when you don't have so much tension in your body. Released a little bit of that lat, teres major. There's still a lot of trigger points in there, but I'm We've only got so much time, so now we're gonna take a look at this posterior deltoid. I'm just gonna release the back of the shoulder. Really opening up these shoulders. Bolder shoulders. I'm just gonna take a soft fist. Do a little bit of smashing here. There's usually a lot of trigger points and twitching in that posterior deltoid. Come in here with a flat elbow. Maybe thumb on thumb. Yeah. This is going to be very tender. We can do some pinching. Stacking that thumb as best as possible. Digging into that posterior deltoid, getting lots of release. Great release. Lots of twitching. Shoulders letting go. There we go. More twitching. That's what we want to see. With all that release and that posterior deltoid, if time were an option, best thing to do is kind of just keep circling back. So now that we've had some release in the posterior deltoid, it would kind of be good to kind of come back to work the lat and see if that's responded. Lat feels a lot better already. Muscles work together, they work in groups, they do similar motions. Release this, it helps release this, helps release the teres major. So now that this has been released, the lat is gonna release a lot better. We can already see the lat's twitching and releasing better. You know, if somebody comes in with low back pain too, we know that that lat comes all the way down to that lumbar dorsal fascia, kind of connects all the way down into here. This is a good way to work the flexors. Nice and slow. This guy's got some Popeye forearms from all the climbing he's been doing. Or mountain biking, or rowing, or pull-ups, or opening cans of spinach. And his pain's gonna be here on that medial epicondyle. You can see he's crashed here a few times. You know, with elbow pain, it's definitely good to loosen up the flexors, but probably more important to consider maybe what else is causing elbow pain, maybe from the neck, the shoulder. Oftentimes we have very overdeveloped biceps and weak triceps, and something I'll probably talk to Nick about is strengthening his triceps, loosening his biceps, and maybe strengthening his extensors, doing some rubber band exercises. Getting some good twitching in there. As you can tell, I'm very detailed with my work. Just working that flexor carpi ulnaris. Just trying to really work one muscle at a time. Let's take a look at the other side. Just scanning. Feels like his right side is his dominant side. Feels tighter, more developed. His muscles feel really stuck. It's like I'm performing surgery on this guy. You know, massage doesn't have to be so routine oriented. I do like to switch it up, try different things. It's kind of like art. Making these videos, sometimes it's a little difficult to show exactly everything that I do because of fitting myself into the camera. But basically, I'm just gonna repeat what I did to the other side on this side. This side feels very tight. Putting our elbow on the QL above the iliac crest, his hip bone, and below the floating ribs. Just taking our time here. See if we can get any release there a little bit. Just gonna pinch that upper trap here. If you get headaches, this is a great place to do some trigger point work on. Most clients will feel this in their head. It'll be very uncomfortable. Feels like your brain's gonna explode. You can see how well Nick's doing, breathing, relaxing, even though this is very painful, very tender. It's such a relief to get rid of the tension. Little swipe through the traps and rhomboids. A lot of tension here. Holy crap. getting some twitching. Just gliding along that trap. Nice. Oh, that's a release. Just looking at the triceps a little bit. Long head of the triceps is a extensor of the shoulder, so triceps have a lot to do with the shoulder. Works together with the lat. If I had more time, I would get more of these trigger points out. You can see how much it's twitching there. I don't know if you can see that, but this might look like it's uncomfortable, but it might be a little uncomfortable. But the serratus anterior muscle kind of protects the ribs. So we're kind of pushing into the lat and the serratus. This really helps free up the shoulder and the ribs. Helps you breathe. Terry's major again. Okay, look right here. You can see how it's releasing there. That's what you want. I don't really want to abuse our thumbs, so. See if we can get rid of this tension in the posterior deltoid. Ooh, we got a twitcher. Look at that. It's twitching on its own. I think this is fun, just like looking for treasure, trigger points, adhesions, getting the muscle to twitch. Right forearm flexors. tension in our forearms. All that typing, texting, grabbing, clenching, gripping, punching. I'm just gonna let it all go. Just gonna get some nice new warm blood in here. Lots of twitching in here. Not sure if you can see that, but just gonna even everything out now.